Hey there, my main YouTube channel may have bit the dust a few months back, but this one could use a good dusting off and some usage. I haven't published a video on here since December. I've been busy doing journalism about the apocalypse that's currently ongoing, you might have noticed. Anyway, for sci-fi fans and trekkers among you, let's talk Star Trek today, specifically Star Trek Enterprise. I think an episode that often gets overlooked in Enterprise's third season is the wonderful stratagem. Desperate to retrieve the location of where the Zindi weapon is being constructed, Archer, having captured the man responsible for its development, Degra, decides to erase his memory, and then he devises an elaborate ploy to win his trust. The episode begins in what the audience and Degra are led to believe is 3 years in the future. Archer and Degra are on a small ship, attempting to escape from an insectoid prison camp. Both men have aged a little bit in that time. Both of them are sporting long, graying hair, and they're looking a little worse for wear. Degra is confused and suspicious, obviously, and Archer informs him that they've been cellmates for several years and became allies after Earth was destroyed by the weapon and the reptilians attacked other Zindi races. Archer tells Degra that the reason he doesn't remember any of this is because his memory has been affected by a bloodworm inside his system, which Archer helps him remove. This was, of course, inserted there for effect by Dr. Phlox to make the whole ruse seem more believable. Everything about this scenario is very believable, and over time, Degra begins to accept this shocking new reality. Archer plays his role perfectly, balancing his need to carefully acquire information from Degra, without being too obvious, but while still maintaining a convincing deception. As Degra sleeps on the shuttle later that night, Archer injects him with a hypospray to ensure he doesn't awaken anytime soon, and that's when the gotcha moment of the episode is played on the audience. As Archer exits the rear of the craft, what we've actually been watching has taken place entirely within a simulator constructed and operated by Tripp and Mayweather in Cargo Bay 2 of Enterprise. The whole charade was carefully planned and orchestrated to a T by the crew. The Enterprise then flashes back and explains how the crew found Degra's ship in the first place and how they concocted the subterfuge. There's a real ingenuity in the execution of this story, and it's reflected in everything from the carefully thought-out ruse to the dialogue, the character interactions, and the clever twists throughout. Archer has fragments of personal information about Degra, which Hoshi has mostly gleaned from Degra's personal files from his ship. The information is enough to make Archer's story sound plausible to Degra. Archer has a hunch that Degra would have been working on the weapon at a location where his family would have been nearby. But of course, Degra is now operating under the false belief that the weapon has already been launched and that Earth has been destroyed. Archer asks him to input coordinates to the location of the colony of his wife and children. They'll head there for safety. Initially, Degra seems reluctant, remembering that from his perspective, it had only been a few days since he considered Archer and humanity to be his enemy. He nevertheless proceeds to enter the coordinates, albeit under encryption, though Hoshi and T'Pol can see what he has input from the command center. It's the location of a red giant called Azati Prime. Assuming the coordinates are authentic, this could be where the weapon is currently located. However, if it isn't, traveling to Azati Prime could be a costly 3-week detour. Later, Enterprise is exposed to radiation from the debris field, where they found Degra's ship. There's a malfunction, and it briefly interrupts the simulation. Out of one of the windows, Degra, from the corner of his eye, sees that the stars briefly turn to static. He begins to twig that something isn't right. He attacks Archer, and they're ultimately forced to end the simulation. They confine Degra to the brig. What happens next is a battle of wits between the two men. Archer knows that Degra's ship has been to Azati Prime recently. Degra attempts to use reverse psychology to convince Archer that the weapon isn't located there, telling him that the coordinates he gave him were meant to appear convincing. He says he gave Archer what he thought he wanted. Degra is trying to save face and keep Archer from traveling to Azati Prime. He tries to make Archer believe that the whole simulation never convinced him and that he was the one playing Archer throughout. But Archer doesn't buy it. He thinks that Degra fell for the ploy up until the simulation malfunctioned. For that reason, Archer believes that Azati Prime is the location of the weapon, but he can't prove it and Degra is maintaining his story. So Archer speaks with Tripp, T'Pol, and Hoshi and tries to discern what the best course of action is. So, here's the conundrum. If Degra didn't fall for the simulation from the start, then there's good reason to believe that the coordinates he gave could be fake. But then, why did he go to the trouble of encrypting them? T'Pol suggests that he possibly did this to make them appear more convincing, like they were important enough to warrant encryption. And that would make a lot of sense. But Archer is convinced that Degra fell for the simulation, and only twigged something was wrong after the malfunction. So the coordinates could very well be genuine. The problem is that they just can't afford to go all the way to Azati Prime based on insufficient evidence. It's a substantial 3-week journey, by which time the weapon could be launched. They need more information to confirm that the weapon is located there, or to find some means of getting there faster than 3 weeks. So Archer asks Trip about these subspace vortices that the Zindi use. They allow their ships to travel half a dozen light years in a couple of minutes. Later, Archer and Trip work in engineering on what we're led to believe is an attempt to open one of these vortices. So we as the audience are under the impression that they're going to try to travel to Azati Prime using one of these vortices. As the ship begins to shake violently, Archer has Degra and his men brought down to engineering. He tells them that they have adapted Zindi technology and they're trying to use it to travel through a subspace vortex. They need their help to stabilize it, otherwise the ship will be destroyed. Lots of shaking and pyrotechnics certainly make it all seem believable. But then, it all stops and the ship settles. Apparently it was successful and Enterprise has emerged from subspace. Archer brings Degra to the bridge. They've reached the coordinates of the Red Giant. To help sell this situation to Degra, Reed says he's detected several Zindi vessels and significant quantities of chemosite, which we know is one of the ingredients of the weapon. Archer commands Mayweather to set course for those chemosite readings. Degra pipes up furiously, telling him that they'll never get close to the weapon and that their defense perimeter will destroy them. Archer realizes they've done it. Degra has let it slip. Hoshi flips the view screen over to display what's really outside. The Red Giant on the screen was a fake. Enterprise never left the debris field. They never went through the vortex. It was another ruse to force Degra to react. And it's a wonderful final twist that even the audience could fall for. Now they know how to find the weapon. It's located at Azati Prime. With the stratagem successful, they return Degra and his crew under sedation to the ship and they wipe their memories of ever being aboard Enterprise. The ship heads off to Azati Prime. Stratagem is an excellent psychological story and it's very enjoyable watching both characters attempting to outwit each other and use clever mind games. As we know, later in that season, Archer and Degra would become allies and would work together to try to prevent the launch of the weapon. It's hard to believe, after watching this episode, that Archer would ever be able to win Degra's trust a few episodes down the line, but he does. This is one of my favorite episodes of the show, engaging throughout with a satisfying conclusion that contributes enormously to setting up the final few episodes of the third season story arc. That concludes this review of Stratagem. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. If you're interested, you can pick up a How Is This A Thing mug from the mug store. There's lots of different designs to choose from. It's very much appreciated and helps to keep the show going. Thanks for watching and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.